1819, English privateer ship the White Lion landed on the shores of Virginia with some 20 captives aboard. Men and women bought in Angola by the Portuguese and then seized by English pirates on their way across the ocean. Upon their arrival, they were exchanged for cattle. It began on a small scale. The slaves worked with Native Americans and Europeans on tobacco, cotton, and rice plantations. But landowners soon saw more of this exploitable workforce. In 1661, a decree was passed banning interracial marriage. In the 18th century, hundreds of thousands of Africans were sent to what would one day become the United States. They parented millions of children, exploited as slaves, mainly in the south of the country. The Declaration of Independence of 1776 didn't free them from their shackles. 8 out of 12 of the first American presidents possessed slaves, even as the abolitionist movement was growing in the industrialized North, and international trafficking was banned in 1808. In 1860, the election of Abraham Lincoln poured fuel on the fire. The southern states seceded, and the Civil War began. After 5 years of fighting, the Confederates surrendered to the Unionists, and the 13th Amendment of the Constitution forced an end to slavery. Then began a new era for the former slaves and their descendants, that of segregation.
Alabama, mm-hmm. and if you were born in Georgia, you sit on the Georgia side. If you're born in in Florida, you sitting in Florida station. Mm. If you're going to Alabama, you sitting in Alabama station. And Grandma was sitting over there in Georgia. Mm-hmm. And I thought Grandma didn't know what she was doing.
Grandma, what was her maiden name?
I mean, what was Grandma's name? I don't know.
Bayard,
that's right, Bayard.
B-Y-E-R-E-R-D.
Arizona.
Mariah.
Mariah. 5 boys and 7 girls.
Yeah. And you?
5 girls and 7 boys. No. 5 boys and 7 girls.
Why? You were saying that you had married Charlie as
well.
Where, Charlie? Okay, I'm just naming them now.
George, Mama, and Emma. And Lucy, and Raya, and Pat, you, and Stella, Uncle Paul, Uncle Kevin, Uncle Julius, and
Uncle Matt.
That's
12. What am I supposed to do?
I want you to give me the history of the Williams family.
I can't do all of that. You have to see Harry May about that.
Harry May gave it to him.
I know, but I like to get it from everybody. I want everybody's point of view.
What about the Williams family? There was a bunch of them to tell me it started out at 13.
13?
There was 13. Grandma had 13. Mm. And then, of course, generations on down from all the sisters. I was just me one. Well, and they had one. And, well, damn it, Rye had the most because she had 5. Right. That's right. But, seems like that one child just runs. And Uncle Julius had one, right? Julius.
All right, so Grandma being Elizabeth, right?
That's right.
Okay.
Elizabeth.
And she had how many children?
13.
13.
Too big for my blood.
And Uncle George had how many? Can you remember how many Uncle George had? 3, wasn't it? Took and,
I don't remember.
But there was 3 of them. Yeah. And Buddy. And Buddy.
Yes.
And Took.
Uh-huh.
And, Oh, Lord, what other ones came? I can't think.
Are these the relatives like in Philadelphia somewhere?
Oh, you talking about
that's Uncle Matthews.
Uncle
Matthews that lives in Philadelphia.
And they all live, I think, just about.
Yeah. Except Dana. Dana's living. I know Dana's living.
Oh, Dana, one of Weezer's girls. Yeah.
I talked to Dana not too long ago.
Yeah, there was 4 of them.
Well, who was Emma Louise?
That was Uncle Matt's daughter.
Yeah, Emma Louise, Elizabeth was the baby, and I call her Jenny, which was the oldest one.
Yeah.
And of course, the girl we were just talking about was in between, and she had 4 kids. Elizabeth only had 1, Shirley.
Shirley's
right. Dead too.
Yeah.
Right. I keep in touch because I was
But Liz had Dana, Shirley, And two boys. Yeah, two boys and two girls.
No, that wasn't Liz. That Liz is the baby. She only had Shirley.
No, not Liz.
Emma.
Emma had Dana, Shirley, but I can't remember those two boys' names. But I talked to Dana not too long ago. Over here from Laramie's house.
You know, we lived in Philly. In 1940, the year just before we came to California, we lived in Philadelphia.
1940, where was I?
No.
He wasn't here.
No, that's for sure. It wasn't 1940, it was about 1944-45.
He still wasn't here.
We come to California in 47. Mm-hmm. See, so we've been out here a long, long time.
Yes, at 47?
1947, we came to California. That's right, Prince Ella was 9 years old.
But still, the trash goes out Tuesday, right? But if we have
enough ice. And Prince Ella is now 54.
Thank you.
Yeah. She about it. She got an 84 too, huh?
Your grandson.
Yeah.
That's the second time my baby went to the bathroom.
Say what?
That's the second time she went.
Oh, okay.
She got to go to the bathroom.
Yeah.
Okay. In Texas, they had a
Matthew.
Earthquake.
It says Matthews under this baby. Matthews is what it says, not Madison, it says Matthews. Born April 1st, 1901, at the attending public schools of Jacksonville, Florida, at Wallace College. She studied library, science, speech at Hampton Institute. What'd you say? Temple and Columbia. What'd you say? City of Jacksonville, and take pride in the years of dedicated and given her life to the education. During the 47 years spent with the Duval County Board of Education, she became librarian. Stanton High School, right. Wow. Okay, wait a minute, Mama. Wait. See, even in here, Uncle Nat, they didn't put your first name in here. They didn't put your first name. They put Nathaniel Braxton, and then they put Daley Braxton after you. Mm-hmm.
You just found out for me the other day.
Because they said, they said Nathaniel Braxton Sr. and Daley Braxton Jr.
And neither one of them right. But you know, and I say,
Rodney and Donald Barringer.
His name is Junior.
And that's right. Son. That's right. He's Junior, he's and Dale is the third.
Well, but he called himself Junior now.
Yeah.
So he changed it to Junior. He said when he went to the army, he went with Junior. But that's not his name.
Hey, how about that?
That's what he chose now.
There you go, Razor Blade. Wow, Lainey was married to Donnie back in 87. I mean, 84 when Granddaddy died and Aunt Stella died. Wow, that was a long time ago. Wow. This stuff fascinates me, you know. We'll be right back.
We'll be right back. Mr. Golden
Mr. Golden, I came to get Boy Real. She called her husband Boy. I came to get Boy Real. What Real? Who said that? Okay, hey, that was her boyfriend. See, she's good, but okay,
oh, okay. Oh, he wasn't supposed to know.
No, right. Okay, okay. And she came, Boy sent her to get the Real.
From Arizona?
Used to be packed and all around the block, way back down there to Beaver Street. And they were trying to get in. And they would get it, and they'd have sometimes two shows a night. And then they would come every other year like that and have this, you know, come home.
Come home and have this show.
And child, you tell my son, they would be so pretty and have costumes and all those clothes you sit back in the dark, they would look so good. And Pet, one year, they were going somewhere for a show, and she was sitting somewhere near a trunk, and the trunk fell over and mashed her and crushed her lungs.
Dang.
That she developed tuberculosis. She stayed sick a long time. She was traveling all out, so when she got sick, she came home, because Uncle Johnny was so hoarse and running around and going with the women on the show, until she got mad and she came home, and she said she was coming home to die, and she came home and got her house, and
that's it.
She died.
Yeah.
She was a pretty
woman.
Johnny made that look like.
Yeah,
no. Johnny made that. And hair come all the way down here, honey.
Oh, wait a minute.
She had pretty curly hair.
Mm-hmm. I thought Johnny made Mama's name was Prince
Owen. That was her name. We call that Pet.
We call her Pet.
We call her Pet. Her name was Prince Owen. And she named after, her daughter is named after her. But Johnny made his name after her daddy.
Pretty like that. Yeah, sure. Johnny named after her dad. And see, when her daddy took her back to home, I said, Pep, one of the Stella keep her. It's Stella wanted the Pep to keep
her. I'm talking to her and she didn't hear.
No, what you said, baby? I'm talking to you about this man die. I got to go.
Let me get on the phone. I'll call Uncle Jimmy. And I say, Uncle Jimmy, everybody's doing this. Let me recount one last story and then you can go. I gotta tell, listen, I know everybody knows that I have to tell. This was the night that Woodrow and I graduated from last
year.
From rain. You know, we had the thing down at the college. And so, Mama, I think you were standing there. I don't know if you were standing out there with Aunt Hammond and Lisa. Lisa and Lady was standing out there, right?
What I tell on you now?
Yeah. I had 10 little girlfriends at that time, but I had one little member. But this one, this girl was somebody from my, for lack of what you would say. And she was a little funk, right? So I'm trying to get rid of this girl, because I'm trying to hook up with my real girlfriend who's graduating with us, right? So when I come out, when we come marching out the thing, you know, coming out, she's standing, you know, they had us roped off police. Yeah. She jumps the rope. Grab me, right? So I'm trying to get rid of her. So I'm walking her out so she can go. So who do I walk into as I come out the door? So now, Lisa was cool. And Harry was there up in trouble. She says, well, Charles, who is this? I said, this is so-and-so. No, this your girlfriend? And I said,
Thank you.
I'm not gonna erase it by no means. Move, Dante. Yeah. I just. This is for your girl.
I'm just shining. This is
for your girl. That's what the light is so bright.
Stop biting.
Stop. Don't bite her. Stop. Look at the TV. See? Come on, see the baby?
Come
look.
On, stop fighting.
Look. See? Look. See the baby? Say hi, baby. Say hi.
I'm good.
Don't hit Dante.
But Dante, you poke.
Dante, move. Now.
Uncle George was the first child. Mama was the second.
And I think Uncle Matt was next to Mama.
Is that Uncle George you mean, my granddad?
No.
And my brother.
Yeah,
but your brother is my granddad.
Yeah,
I'm talking about my mama's sister.
told him. He just wanted his name
to come. All my sisters and brothers.
It was 12 of them. My brother, see, I'm your grandmama's child, and George is your grandmama's child. Johnny, George, Johnny, Alan, Matt, and me.
So let's go back up one step. All right. To Elizabeth's children.
She had 12.
She must have moved with a G. Okay, go ahead. Tell me who all it was.
Who all the children were?
All right, Elizabeth.
Daily Nathaniel Braxton Sr. What was granddaddy and Aunt Letha's daddy's name? Yeah. Was it Joe or John? Joe? Joe Berringer? Okay. I thought it was Joe Berringer.
And your mother's name was Prinsella, right?
Prinsella.
Prinsella Berringer. B with an E. B-E-R-I-N-G-E-R.
B-E-R.
R-I-N-G-E-R. That's right.
That's how Dinah spelled his name for many years.
Well, B-E. That's B-E. But yeah. The other Berringer, Joe Berringer, Jordan and his dad was spelled with an H. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And they're passing off for brothers.
Yeah.
And one of them married Aunt Mariah. And one of them married my mother. And they
what
were passing for brothers. Mm. But they weren't brothers, they were just friends. Because my dad was born in Alabama. And they moved to Georgia. Where in your great grandpa was born in Georgia. That's where they tied up.
What city?
Huh?
You know what's it?
Columbus, I think.
Columbus, huh?
Yeah.
Sure. So where was Elizabeth from? Okay, so what were the children's name? What were Elizabeth's children's name? All of them. All 12.
Okay, now I was going
to
say. You know, your aunt's brother, you see, she had about two or two. She had two of them to die, and I never didn't know. I know one of them.
She had Lucy and Emma. Lucy and Emma.
Oh, Lucy and Emma.
I could name three of them.
Uncle Julius.
Uncle McKinley. Mack.
Uncle McKinley. Uncle Carl.
That's
she had five boys and seven girls.
Mm-hmm.
Little boy and girls.
Exactly.
You named
him.
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 You
always known her as Mariah.
Oh, they see, so they used to just call her Mariah. But I explained it to you when he was a little boy, her name was Marie.
She said, Willa told me.
See, Brother Finn told me that. And so, when John came one time, you know, John would always come to our house, but he wouldn't go around there to his nephew. That was his nephew. That was his sister's child. And when he came, he told them, they went to a funeral, and they stole it and beat it. I think Mama didn't go, but they went to this funeral, I think it must have been Debbie's funeral or somebody. It was, I think. And so he told them, now let me tell y'all something. So y'all stand up. John told her.
I don't know John.
You don't remember John Johnson?
You mean Uncle John's son?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Uncle John.
And he said, let me tell y'all something. If y'all stand over here think y'all better than them over there, say, honey, y'all better go over there and grieve with them, honey, because they've chopped y'all and hunted their lives and everything else. Mm-hmm. Say, your color don't mean nothing. Now, he came back and told Mama. He said, I got him told. He used to always come out Mama.
Jacqueline!
You're part of the family.
Turn this around.
Oh, I'm sorry, Donnie looks just like you. Oh, I like it the other way around.
No, well,
don't
you? That'll work too, but actually, this is Donnie's mother.
You're kidding. I thought you was going to say sister.
No.
That's my wife, see?
I know.
So you like her already, I can tell.
Look, what'd I tell you?
I gotta go find Lawrence.
James Musgrove here. What's your name? Greg? James Musgrove, Miss Grove, all real Donnie B.
Mr. Barringer. Jackie!
Hi.
Go kiss her there. Kissy poo.
This is the lovely homeowner. She's the one that runs things around this part. Her name is Jacqueline.
Bruce's kiss. Thank you.
This is Donnie B, my lovely cousin, Donnie B.
Hey, in the right place, next to home.
She wrote that family, but I ain't got no family.
Ain't family, ain't family. Your family better than you and Orson.
Do you have a...
Don't be thinking me with my phone.
What was his name?
Oh, Lord. What is
my money? Do you have someone in your family by the...
He's gonna witness you.
To you, Barbara. Wish you could have been here. Love you. Does it talk to?
Yeah, it does.
All right.
It's here everywhere.
Yeah.
And when you're gonna have to get a copy of this. There's some words in there you're gonna want to hear.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Oh, yeah.
But his mother and I is really tight.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Oh,
his mom.
Really?
So
you guys are cousins.
Second. Tell her I got my teeth in my pocket. Bro.
That's what she keeps us too. So it's all right.
Tell I can eat meat and apples and steak and everything.
But don't you tell Mama that she got her teeth in the pocket. But I said that's okay because that's what she keeps us too.
She told me to let you know this song that we're playing is my friend's song who came in with me, James. That's his song that we're playing right now.
Here it comes.
comes right now.
That's Donnie. That's his brother.
Oh.
I don't know what Donnie do besides.
Right there, Priscilla. This man wants you to come. See you. This is him on the Barringer.
Thank you, sir.
Hey, why don't you break out a little bit.
Go ahead and eat, man. Don't sweat it.
Break out just a couple lyrics.
Yo, Larry.
Break out a couple lyrics. You need something to drink?
You really want me to do that?
Yeah, break out just a couple lyrics because Donnie has got this on tape.
When he was all around, he was so
this is my boy.
But he's going to break out some lyrics. Now he's leave
this is my one and only boy.
That's right.
Okay, and being the conservative I am,
uh-huh.
I'm going to let him know that I love him, and I'm going to tune him in.
Hey!
Little complex type of stuff, you know. Someone with a new era.
New era.
I'm on my old mind like the Clippers and Edges. In line, squirt off these MCs like Einstein. Hitting blunts and wine when I dine. My rhymes intertwine on fat tracks that back up fat raps. Like the offensive line for quarterbacks. I bet you didn't figure that. You lay your hat when these IE reps take attack. The majority of the blacks give us love like Michael Jackson's glove. The rest blow sets cracking speed, spending dubs. Won't y'all get bit up? Like a middle finger to a po-po for y'all to move built and get told. Be under the beat of too long. Nah, I don't even want to go more.
decided that the Redskins should allow Phoenix to claim it.
Here is something for Brighton.
I got this.
I like but I want to go away now. I want to see my mother and my father.
Here is
the